Hariwam students, welcome to the online biology class. Today we are going to start chapter 8, How do organisms reproduce? Under this lesson we are going to discuss about what is meant by reproduction and what is the significance of it and how many types of reproductions are there. In each and every type of reproduction, some other methods through which different types of organisms reproduce, like fission, fragmentation, regeneration, vegetative propagation, and spore formation. In the same way, we are going to discuss about how does reproduction take place in flowering plants and how does reproduction take place in human beings. Under this lesson, we are going to discuss about all these topics. Before going to know how do organisms reproduce, first we have to know why do organisms reproduce. Why do organisms reproduce? In the last chapter, we have learnt about different types of life process like nutrition, respiration, transportation and excretion, which are very, very essential to maintain the life of one individual, one organism. In the same way, do you think that is reproduction also essential to maintain the life of individual or organism? Unlike all these essential life processes such as nutrition, respiration, transportation and excretion, reproduction is not necessary to maintain the life of individual. But what is the significance of this reproduction process in the life of an organism? What is the significance? Why do organisms reproduce? Why do organisms reproduce their young ones? Because through the reproduction only, organisms continue their race on this earth. Race means they increase their number. They increase the population in their species. If they don't reproduce, they would become extinct from this earth. They maintain their existence on this planet. That's why every organism needs reproduction, but not it is essential for maintaining their life. It is necessary to maintain their number, to maintain their existence, not to maintain their life. Without reproduction also organisms can live. But to overcome the problem of extinction from this earth, they have to continue their number. They have to improve their population on their species. So they have to reproduce, they have to give their young ones. For example, if you observe your surroundings, you might have seen dogs give puppies, cats give kitten. In the same way, if you observe any other living organism, they produce exact copy of themselves. Is it right? You might have a doubt. How do organisms create the exact copy of themselves? This is because of hereditary material which is present in the cells of the body. Now let us discuss about what is that hereditary material, where it is present inside our body. How do organisms create exact copy of themselves? That is because of DNA molecule. What is meant by DNA molecule? It is also called deoxyribonucleic acid. Where do we find this DNA molecule? DNA is the genetic material found in the chromosomes, which are present in the nucleus of a cell. If you see, this DNA is also known as blueprint and master copy. It contains the information for inheritance of features. That means DNA is responsible for the transfer of characteristics from parents to the next generation. The DNA is the information site for making proteins. And each specific type of protein leads to a specific type of body design. Thus, it is the DNA molecule that determines the body design of an individual. Therefore, it can be concluded that it is the DNA which gets transferred from parents to the offsprings and makes them look similar. So we can tell that DNA determines the body structure of an organism. During reproduction, the reproduction cell gets duplicate. That means you all know that DNA is one double helical structure. That means two strands are there which are helical to each other. How do this helical like structure is responsible for creating the exact copy of individual? If you see the process, the first reaction takes place in this process is DNA duplication. What is meant by DNA duplication? That is nothing but two strands are there in one DNA molecule. They get separate from each other. This is called DNA duplication. DNA gets separate from each other and make two different cells. This process is called DNA duplication. And each and every separate cell, they generate the exact copy which are similar in structure but may not be identical to each other. What's happening in the next step? Each and every cell, after separation, after duplication, two cells are formed. Every cell of the DNA, it generates the copy of the helical strand, the exact copy of the helical strand, which will be similar in structure but may not be identical to each other. Because of this only, organisms are present in different variations. This process of formation of exact copy of the DNA molecule is called DNA copying. What is meant by DNA copying? DNA copying means the production of an exact copy of the original DNA. And this is very important in reproduction process. But the process of DNA copying will have some variations each time, which leads to the stability of the population and formation of new species. In the previous slide, I told you already, the DNA copies that are generated are similar to each other but not identical to each other. Based on this, every organism contains some variations each time, which leads to the stability of the population and formation of new species. I told you that DNA copying leads to so many variations in the organisms. Do you think that variations are important for the survival of species? Yes, variation is very important for the survival of species. Why is variation beneficial to the species? Variations are beneficial to the species than individual because sometimes for a species, the environment conditions change so drastically that their survival becomes difficult. To understand this one clearly, for example, if the temperature of water increases suddenly, then most of the bacteria living in that water would die. Only a few variants that are resistant to heat would be able to survive. However, if these variants were not there, then the entire species of bacteria would have been destroyed. Thus, these variants help in the survival of the species. In this way, if you see, variations are very important for the survival of species, and it allows some individuals to withstand to the changes that are happening in the environment, to maintain the number of species, to maintain the number of population. The variations are very important for the survival of species. So we can tell that DNA copying during reproduction is very important process. Now let us know what is meant by reproduction. Then how do organisms reproduce? Up to now we have discussed why do organisms reproduce. But now we are going to discuss about how do organisms reproduce through different methods. First we have to know What is meant by reproduction? Reproduction is the process through which the organisms generate new individuals of the same kind is called reproduction. What is meant by reproduction? Reproduction is the formation of new individuals from the existing organisms. Reproduction is the process by which organisms generate new individuals of the same kind. In other words, we can tell that reproduction is the formation of new individuals from the existing organisms is called reproduction. If you see, reproduction is divided into two types. What are those? One is asexual reproduction, second one is sexual reproduction. How many types of reproductions are there? There are two types of reproductions, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. What is meant by reproduction? Reproduction is the formation of new individuals of the same kind from pre-existing organisms. This is called reproduction. How many types of reproductions are there? Two types. What are those? Asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. In this video, let us discuss about only asexual reproduction. Now let us see what is meant by asexual reproduction. It is the process of formation of new individual from a single parent without any type of fertilization is called asexual reproduction. Single parent involves in this type of reproduction. That's why it is called asexual reproduction. What is meant by asexual reproduction? It is the process of formation of new individual from single parent without any fertilization is called asexual reproduction. Again, if you see here, this asexual reproduction is classified into six groups. What are they? They are fission, fragmentation, regeneration, budding, vegetative propagation, and spore formation. Various organisms reproduce through different type of methods through asexual reproduction. Based on what you know? Based on their body design. Now, let us discuss about each and every method of asexual reproduction. First, fission. Let us start with the fission, one of the asexual reproduction. Fission means division. It is the type of asexual reproduction in which the parent cell splits into two or more daughter cells. We can observe this type of reproduction in unicellular organisms. Many bacteria and amoeba simply splits into two equal halves. For example, if you see in amoeba only, amoeba is one unicellular organism which does not contain any regular shape. This type of organisms splits into unequal halves. Two daughter cells are formed because of this fission. This division can take place in any plane. It may be in horizontal, it may be in vertical, it may be in diagonal. The division can take place in any plane and it gives rise to two daughter cells which is called binary fission. Fission again, if you observe, based on the number of daughter cells formed in the reproduction, fission is divided into two types. First one, binary fission. Second one, multiple fission. First one, binary fission. Second one, multiple fission. We can observe binary fission in the unicellular organisms like amoeba. That means amoeba gives rise to two daughter cells only. Amoeba is unicellular organism. It produces two daughter cells. That's why it is called binary fission method. If you observe other type of organisms like malarial parasite, Plasmodium, it divides, it reproduces through multiple fission. That means in this type of reproduction, more daughter cells are produced. Binary fission takes place in amoeba type of organisms, Multiple fission takes place during unfavorable conditions in malarial parasite like Plasmodium. During unfavorable conditions, amoeba also reproduces through multiple fission. Okay, this is the first type of asexual reproduction in which single parent involves, and this single parent simply splits into two or more daughter cells. Fission is divides into two types, binary fission and multiple fission, based on the number of daughter cells. Binary fission means two daughter cells are produced. Multiple fission means more daughter cells are produced through this type of reproduction. Binary fission is observed in amoeba. Multiple fission, best example, Plasmodium, which is one malarial parasite. Second important asexual reproduction method is fragmentation. It is the type of asexual reproduction in which the parent cell is simply breaks up into smaller pieces upon maturation. This type of reproduction we can observe in Spirogyra. Spirogyra is a category of algae, green color plants, which are in filamentous structures. After they get maturation, each and every Spirogyra simply breaks up into so many pieces. Later, each and every piece grows as a developed individual. This type of reproduction is called fragmentation. We can observe this type of asexual reproduction in Spirogyra. Spirogyra comes under the category of algae. Now let us start with the third important asexual reproduction, that is nothing but regeneration. What is meant by regeneration? Some particular type of organisms have the ability to reproduce one complete organism from single part of the body. It is a type of asexual reproduction in which single parent involves. For example, if you see simple organisms like Hydra and Planaria, look at the picture here, it is one planaria. It has the ability, these type of organisms have the ability. If the organism cut or broken up into many pieces, each and every piece has the ability to give rise to one complete new organism. This type of reproduction is called regeneration. Each piece will develop into a new individual. Because these type of organisms have some specialized cells which differentiate into tissues. These organized tissues form one complete organism. This type of organism reproduction is called regeneration. It is one type of asexual reproduction. If the organism broken up into several pieces, each piece will develop into a new individual. Best examples for regeneration, Hydra and Planarians. Now let us discuss about budding, which is one of the asexual reproduction method. It is the type of reproduction in which a bulb-like structure, a bud, develops as an outer growth due to repeated cell divisions at one specific site on the parent body, and this bud will develop into one new individual. Look at the picture here. You have seen, you have learned this type of reproduction method in your lower sections only. This is the process of budding in Hydra. What happened in this process? On the parent body, at any one specific site, it develops one small bulb-like structure which is called bud. Because of repeated cell divisions, this bulb is formed on the parent body. And slowly it increases in size, it grows in size and develops into one new individual. When it fully matures, it detaches from its parent body and it leads its own life. It develops into one new individual. This process is called budding. Formation of budding on the parent body cell, grows in size and detaches from the parent body and leads its life as an adult organism. This process is called budding, we observe this type of reproduction in hydra. Let us see one more asexual reproduction, that is vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is one type of asexual reproduction in which the plant parts like roots, stem, leaves develop into new plants. Up to now we have seen different type of organisms which reproduce through different types of asexual reproduction methods. If you observe plants, plants also reproduce asexually with the process of vegetative propagation. Why is this type of asexual reproduction called vegetative propagation? Do you know the parts of a plant? A plant contains roots, stems, branches, leaves, flowers. In all these plant parts, roots, stems, leaves are called vegetative parts. Flowers are reproductive parts. If one new plant develops from any one of these vegetative parts, this process is called vegetative propagation. What are the vegetative parts in a plant? Root, stem, leaves. If a new plant develops from all these vegetative parts, this type of reproduction, this type of asexual reproduction is called vegetative propagation. Different type of plants reproduce in different methods. Look at the picture here. It is the example of vegetative propagation through leaves. Bryophyllum is one type of plant which reproduces through leaves. If you observe the margins of the leaves, it contains small bulbils. Small bulbs like structure here. These are all small plants. If these small plants fall on the soil, they grow as a new plant. This is one type of vegetative propagation which reproduces through the leaves. Example, bryophylla. Look at this type of vegetative propagation in one flowering plant like chrysanthemum. It reproduces through stem. Stem produce one small sucker which grows like a new plant. This is one type of vegetative propagation. Main stem produces another small sucker like structure, and later it develops adventitious roots and it produces leaf like structures, and again it acts as one new plant. This is one type of vegetative propagation which reproduces through the part of stem. This is also one type of reproduction, vegetative propagation, which we observe in aquatic plants. Example, Pistia. Pistia is one aquatic plant which reproduces through the vegetative part like stem. Here, these are two plants. The stem of one plant produces one horizontal like structure which is called offset. And this offset produces another one plant in the water itself. This is one type of vegetative propagation we can observe in one aquatic plant like Pistia. Look at this picture here. This is another plant, potato. This is also reproduces through vegetative propagation only. If you see one potato, you may observe so many notches on the surface of the potato which are called eyes. From each and every eye, it forms one aerial shoot system and small root system. If you cut that area and if you sow that one in the soil, that one grows into one new plant. Here also, it is called vegetative propagation, which reproduces through the vegetative part of the plant, which is nothing but stem. Potato is the modified stem which stores the food material. Potato is stem, modified stem. If you see the advantages of vegetative propagation, what are the advantages of this vegetative propagation? The plants developed by the vegetative propagation are genetically similar in same way. Plants developed by vegetative propagation bear flowers, fruits earlier than those raised from the seeds. But hundreds of genetically similar plants can be propagated from a single parent cell. We can reproduce hundreds of same plants from a single parent cell through this process of vegetative propagation. The plants which do not produce proper seeds can be propagated only by this method. The plants which do not contain seeds can be reproduced through this type of propagation, vegetative propagation. It needs more attention than those raised from seeds. These are the advantages of vegetative propagation. Now let us discuss about one more type of asexual reproduction, that is spore formation. This is one type of asexual reproduction we can observe in fungi category. Fungi are non-green plants which do not contain chlorophyll. Look at the picture here. It is one fungi named Rhizopus. If you see the structure of this organism, it contains so many thread-like structures. This is one thread-like structure, this is one thread-like structure, these are long thread-like structures which are called hyphae. And these hyphae, at the end of each hyphae, they contain one bulb-like structure, one blob-like structure which is called sporangium. Inside the sporangium, this rhizopus produce small spore-like structures. So many spores are produced in each sporangium. After it gets maturation, that sporangium bursts and so many spores enter into the air. Whenever these spores get moisture body, then they settle on that moisture content body and they start growing into one another new individual, new organism. In this way, some type of organisms reproduce. It is one type of asexual reproduction in which the spores in the sporangium will come out when matured and each spore will develop into new individual. Example of spore formation, Rhizopus. It is one type of fungi category. All the methods of reproduction what we have discussed so far, in all these type of reproductions, the new generations are generated from single parent only. If you observe in fission, regeneration, spore formation, either it is budding or vegetative propagation, whatever method it is, in all these type of reproductive methods, single parent is involved in the creation of new generation. That's why this type of reproduction is called asexual reproduction. In the next video, we will discuss about second method of reproduction, that is sexual reproduction. I hope you have understood the process of asexual reproduction take place in different organisms. Hari Om. Thank you.